Okay, so welcome back. So this is the part 2 or the continuation of our chapter 1. Because a while ago, my microphone was being muted. That's why wala kayong marinig doon sa first na video. Okay? So, let's move on to the basic nature of criminal investigation. It involves the systematic process of identifying facts or information, or the so-called investigative leads. Number 2, gathering, sorting, then processing facts and information. Number 3, preserving evidences, evaluation of evidences, and lastly, presenting of evidence. Okay? So, once the person commits crime, the task of our investigator is to gather evidence. But before gathering evidence, you need to identify facts or information or yung mga leads natin. Okay? After gathering and sorting and processing the information, you need now to preserve the evidences. Okay? After preserving the evidence, you need to evaluate the evidence before presenting it in the court proceeding or for court presentation. So, ayan po yung systematic process natin ng for criminal investigation. Okay? Then, after that, we have now the role of criminal investigators. Okay? A criminal investigator is a fact finder. He collects facts to accomplish a threefold aim. Okay? Remember, the threefold aim of criminal investigation, number 1 is to identify the guilty party. Okay? So, una dyan, once the person commits crime, you need to identify who commits or who committed the said crime. Okay? Kailangan mong alamin kung sino. Number 2, we have to apprehend the guilty party. Ngayon, sinabi na natin or sabihin na natin na na-identify mo na yung perpetrator. Kailangan mo na ngayon siyang i-apprehend or arestuhin. Because you need to incarcerate him. Kailangan mo siyang ikulong. Okay? And then afterwards, you need to provide evidences of his criminal guilt. Okay, like in the previous video, sabi nga natin, kailangan mong magkalat ng mga ebidensya para mapatunayan mo na yung taong ikinulong mo, yung taong inaresto mo, ay ang talagang may sala or ang gumawa ng krimen. Okay? So, the investigator is the person deputized by the law to conduct close analysis on criminal cases armed with the 4 tools of investigation. Okay, yung tinatawag 4 eyes of investigation, we have the information, interview, interrogation, and lastly, we have the instrumentation. Thus, criminal investigators plays the very vital role in the process of solving criminal cases for eventual administration of justice. A criminal investigator may be employed by a public or private prosecutor, or he may be directly used by the court to find solution of a criminal cases. Okay, hindi po basta-basta yung mga ginagawang mga trabaho ng ating mga investigador, because they should be equipped with enough knowledge and skills so that they could be considered as a competent investigator. According to Pedro Solis, criminal investigator have the following duties. Okay, ito naman yung kanyang mga in-enumerate na mga iba't ibang duties ng investigador natin. Number 1, establish that a crime was in fact committed under the law. So, syempre, kailangan mong alamin kung meron ba talagang krimen na nangyari o meron talagang batas na nalabag. Okay? So, ngayon, pagka na-establish mo na meron ng krimen na nangyari, number 2, you need to identify and apprehend. Parang pinagsama lang yung kanina. Kanina, i-identify mo yung una. Number 2, apprehend dun sa threefold aim. Ngayon, pinagsama niya. You need to identify and apprehend. Kailangan mong alamin kung sinong nag-commit at nang sa ganon, siya ay yung mahuli. Okay? Then after that, you need to recover stolen property pagka merong mga ninakaw. And then after that, you need to assist the state in prosecuting the party charged with a crime. You need to help the government. Okay? Kailangan magtulungan yung gobyerno natin nang sa ganun, ma-prove mo yung guilt ng isang tao. Okay? Next, in the performance of his duties, yung mga criminal investigators natin, the investigator must seek to establish the 6 cardinal points of investigation. Number 1, okay, remember, we have the 5 W's and 1 H. Okay, we have the 5 wives and 1 husband na sinasabi natin. Okay, particularly, we have what, who, when, where, why, and how. Okay, when we say what, okay, ano? Okay. What specific crime was committed? Ano ba yung krimen na kinumit niya? Number 2, who did the crime? Sino nga ba ang perpetrator? Sino nga ba ang nagkumit ng crime? Number 3, when did it happen? Kailan nga ba ito nangyari? You need to be specific in taking down notes when it happened. Okay? Particularly, ano ba yung araw? Ano ba yung oras? Number 4, where was the crime committed? Saan nangyari ang krimen? Okay. Number 5, we have why was it committed? Ano nga ba yung dahilan? Bakit kinumit nung tao na yon yung certain crime na yon? Okay? Because there are several reasons why person commits crime. Okay, alam natin na maraming rason. Bakit nga bang isang tao ay nagkukumit ng crime? It is either number 1, is poverty, kahirapan. Okay, walang pera, walang makain. That's why nag-commit siya ng crime. Okay? Another reason why people commit crime is anger, jealousy, and also revenge. Yan yung mga usual na reason bakit nga ba ang tao nagko-commit ng crime. And also number 6, how was the crime committed? Paano nga ba ginawa yung crime na yon? Okay? What particular strategies or techniques ang mga ginamit ng offender na yon para lang makumit yung crime? So, you need to be aware of the 6 cardinal points of investigation, the 5 W's and 1 H. Lastly, for trichotomy of criminal investigation. So, when we say trichotomy kasi, it's considered the 3 classification or 3 categories. Okay, for criminal investigation, number 1, we have their training. Okay? Training being a critical factor in developing good and competent investigator, it is the key to freedom from bondage of ignorance. One cannot become a competent investigator if he is ignorant. Syempre naman, how are you going to say that the investigator is competent? Well, in fact, he is ignorant. Ignorante. Okay, walang alam. Thus, ignorance is not tolerated in the field of criminal investigation. Hindi nila papayagan na i-employ ang isang investigador nang walang alam. That's why, dapat he is equipped with enough knowledge and skills so that he is considered an effective investigator or a competent investigator. Okay? Ignorance is not allowed or tolerated in the field of criminal investigation because highly competent criminal investigators are effective weapons against criminality. Okay? Dapat marunong sila. Dapat may alam sa kanilang mga pinaggagawa. The source of competent investigators is well-organized training. So, para masabi mo daw ng isang investigator ay competent at effective, dapat meron siyang mga sources of training or mga organized na training, okay? Which is related to their field of work, okay? Note that training is a dynamic process and it never ends. So, ito po ay continuing. Habang tumatagal, we need to develop our skills and knowledge. Number 2, we have tools Okay. What is the significance of tools in investigation? So far, it outweighs its literal meaning. Okay. Ang tinatawag kasi nating tools sa criminal investigator, ang pinakamahalaga dyan ay ang information. Okay. It said here that information is the key tool in criminal investigation. In fact, it is the most powerful weapon of investigators, more powerful than a gun or money. Kasi papaano ka nga ba magkakandak ng investigation? Papaano mo yan sisimulan? Okay? Kung wala ka namang mga information leads. Okay? So, it will not prosper. So, it's very important that you are being able and you are very resourceful in having or in providing information. So, take note that the best tool for criminal investigation is information. And lastly, we have techniques. Okay, so today, the war against criminals is not won by the battle of arms, but through the battle of techniques. Okay? So, ang masasabi ko dyan is that, sa ngayon, sa ating century ngayon, okay, hindi na to labanan ng lakas. Okay, but rather, it's now the battle of techniques. Kumbaga, dapat magaling kang gumawa ng mga strategy mo bilang isang investigator. Dapat matalas ang isipan mo. Okay? Some people say that the courtroom battle is not won by clash of words and wealth. Okay? But through legal battle of techniques. Okay? So ngayon, kung dati siguro, you can win a case by using your wealth, kayamanan. Pero ngayon, wala nang ganun. But rather, you can fight a case with the use of your techniques. So as a criminal investigator, dapat matalas ang isip mo, malawak ang pag-iisip mo so that you could give your insights about the investigation that you are doing, okay? A criminal investigator with an obsolete technique. Kumbaga, pag sinabi nating obsolete technique kasi is that hindi na siya ganoon useful. Kumbaga, luma na yung ginagamit mong technique, okay? Sinabi dyan, an investigator with an obsolete technique is like a soldier who enters the combat zone without weapon. Para ka lang daw pumunta sa isang gera na wala man lang daw kaarmas-armas. Okay, kasi nga, hindi na useful yung mga ginagamit mong mga strategies, mga techniques. Okay? So, technique is the essence of many facets of tactical strategy in investigation. One secret of successful investigator is they maintain sympathetic image. They project charismatic personality and consequently, they are being looked upon as a friend and not a foe. So, dapat parang lumalabas dito na ikaw ay talagang kakampi nila. Dapat hindi ka lumabas na parang ikaw yung kalaban, ikaw yung kontrabida. Okay, but rather, you need to show a very sympathetic image and likewise with charismatic personality. Okay, so that hindi ka magmukhang kalaban. So, yun po yung mga trichotomy ng ating criminal investigation. So, we have training. Number two, we have tools. Sabi nga natin, for training, dapat competent ka bilang isang investigator. Dapat nag-undergo ka ng mga organized na trainings. Number two, tools. Sabi nga natin, the number one tool for investigation is information. And number three, dapat malawak ang pag-iisip mo, strategic or dapat strategize yung isip mo nang sa ganun, mapanalo mo yung kaso. Okay? So, again, as an overview or review to our chapter 1, diba, we discuss what is investigation, what are the different kinds of investigation. We discuss also what are the types of investigators, what are their roles. We all know that investigator plays a very vital role in the conduct of investigation, okay? Because their task is to give or to administer justice to the victim and also to our government. So, please make sure that you are updated on the next video so that you can answer your activity. Okay, so that's all for this discussion. Be updated for more videos. So, thank you.